Yo, what's up, my brother? What's up, my sister? This is your boy, Oscar Ntege, again with yet another amazing video. Now, in this particular video today, we are going to look at how to color grade an image. How do you color grade an image in a way that it pops, in a way that it glams up? Now, when you look at this particular image, it has a blue color cast on it. And what we need to do, we want to make this image vibrant. We want to make it pop. We want to make, to glamorize the whole image. And the skin editing was done using frequency separation. And if you want to know how I did the skin editing and the like, of course, click the link up there and up there in the card and see how I went on to do the whole frequency separation bit. Three things. One, we're going to first remove this blue color cast and put the colors right of the whole image. Then we're going to make the skyline vibrant, and also we're going to work on the skin tones so that we have them subtle. And then we're going to try to shrink the tonal values of these particular highlights in the whole image. Ready? Let's dive into this. Now, here we go. Come here into the adjustment layers, just right here. And then we're going to get into selective color. Now, how do we remove the blue color cast? Now, removing the blue color cast here, we just come into the neutrals, just right here. Yeah. And then you come onto the yellow knob. Okay, let me first show you something. Now, I'll press Ctrl or Command B on my, I'll select this and press Ctrl B on my computer. If you want to understand how color works in Photoshop, you have to understand this particular panel. Now, when you look at cyan, what color is opposite cyan? It is red. An indication if the picture has too much reds, definitely you have to move it towards the cyan bit in order for the reds to reduce. Yeah, but we are not going to use that right now. And if the picture has too much of magenta, definitely you have to move it towards the green side. And if it has a lot of blue, definitely you move it towards the warm side. But we choose not to use this because this particular knob adjusts everything, the whole image at once, basically. And I want to tackle individual colors, okay? So that's why I don't choose this. So let me just close this. But all you have to do, you have to know that this side is comprised of the CMYK, though the black is missing, the K is missing, but the CMYK, then this side is of the RGB. This is like the light color wheel. It is like the version of the color wheel, but in light. Look at it as different colored lights. Making sense? Okay, let me just now get into the whole thing. Now, here's the thing. I come into selective color here, double click. I get into the neutrals. Now, remember what color is opposite yellow? It is blue. So if I move this towards this side, of course, it is going to bring more yellows, but we don't want the yellows to be too much. So what do we do? I just come and, you know, just move it slightly up there, right? You know, so that you reduce the blues. Then I come into the blacks. Also, when you look at the blacks, they have a little bit of blue. So what do? We just come and just darken them just a little bit like that, so that we make them a bit, her hair blacker. So the next thing we're going to do, we're now going to work on the skin tones. And what colors are comprised of the skin tones? Yes, you guessed right. It is reds and oranges. So we're going to work onto the reds. So when you look at these particular skin tones, definitely, you realize that, yeah, the reds are a lot. So we are going to come and just tone them down. But the advantage of you adding in red, it makes the image even pop more. It makes most of the blemishes run out of the image. So the people usually ask me, how do you edit your pictures? When you look at most of my portraits, they have a little bit of too much red. Why? Because with red light, when somebody's under red light, all the acne, all the those particular blemishes run away. They fade away. Actually, those days when we were printing, I used to tell the guy at the printer, please add in just a little bit of red so that the images come out with more glam. So usually what I do, I I don't push it towards the cyan. I usually add in a little bit of red, you know, by just pushing it slightly in the negative sides. Because remember, what color is opposite cyan? Of course, it is red. Okay, so we come into magenta here as well. So for the magenta, I will just come and, of course, just punch it slightly at the front. For the yellows, I usually leave them as is. So the next thing we're going to do right now, I'm just going to now create a stamp and we get into the camera raw filter and begin working now on the general image outlook and shade. Since I've worked on the individual tones, let me just show you the before and after. That's the before of how it was, and this is the after. See how it is taking shape? We have corrected the white balance. We've also corrected the skin tones. Of course, there is nothing like perfect skin tones. This is a question of test. Yeah, so we're just going to come here and create, we are going to come click onto this and then we press Control or Command Alt Shift and E for us to create a stamp. I would say this again, Control Alt Shift and E in order for you to create a stamp of all the effects that are below the whole image. So we're going to come and click onto this and then get into the filter. You say camera raw filter just here. And then what we are going to do, we're just going to come into this. Where is it? The color mixer, just right here. And then we're going to get onto the blue, onto the knob here, the saturation knob. And we're going to make the blue pop by just increasing the saturation just right there. Okay. Then the next thing we're going to do, we're also going to come into the basic corrections here. And then we're going to just come, I'm going to just punch down the highlights. Now, this one is going to help me to keep the skin tones a bit subtle, you know, without them overly popping. So I'll still come punch down the highlights so that I keep the skin tones a bit subtle. And I'll also come and punch down the whites. When you look at it, it is losing its contrasty feel. But when you look at it, it's losing its contrasty feel. It's getting that dynamic kind, that kind of HDR feel. I don't want, because when if I increase the shadows, it will get that HDR look. I don't, personally, I don't like that kind of look. I still want to get that gradation from light and shadow. That's why I usually come and punch down the shadows just a little bit so that it is dark. So that the skin tones are, you know, more, I get that, it feels like you can go all around the whole image when you have at least a contrast between light and shadow. In the artists call this chiaroscuro, you know, that gradation from light and dark. But of late, I see a lot of images that have, that show every detail, like have that HDR kind of look, and you lose that beauty of that chiaroscuro. You want to maintain that, you know, in your images. So the next thing we are going to do right now, I'm just going to come and also boost a bit of the textures. I know I wasn't supposed to come and do this, and I don't take it overboard. I just come and just boost it just a little bit, you know, for just. Then I'll just come and pump up the vibrancy a little bit. When you look at it, why I'm not using the saturation, because saturation is just going to crash, you know, and vibrancy is just a clever way of us saturating without distorting the colors of an image. Now, how do I bring back the other popping tones? This is where it becomes interesting. This is the amazing thing you're going to realize. I use the curves adjustment layer. So I come into the curves here and then I just pull up the highlight right there. And then I just still come and punch down the shadows. Remember, I love contrasting between light and shadow, and pull these just a little bit down. So I don't take it overboard. So I'll just come and also try brightening it up, and I give it that cine style kind of look, you know, that kind of film grain on it. Now I love that kind of feel. Okay, now let's look at the before and after. I mean, I'll just put all these in a group. That's the before, and look at the after. before and after. Isn't that amazing, guys? Isn't, I mean, if you could turn an average image into being this glamorous. Now, how about when you're able to take images that are super awesome? By the way, if you want to become a super great retoucher by next Friday, click the first link in the description below and enroll into the Retouching Secrets Masterclass. It is actually right now going on promotion. It is going at 85% off. Get your opportunity, grab this one-time offer right now. And of course, take your photography to the next level. I'll see you in the next video, and adios.